Hey guys, Steven at Rock Solid again. Just finishing up another job. This is Josh Payne's Camaro from Georgia. Originally an LT car, obviously it's not anymore. Just do a little walk around and tell you about some things we did to it. The motor that's in here now is a mock-up motor. He originally had somebody else do the cage and somewhat of a tube front. But for what Josh wanted, he wanted the turbo down low, he wanted the radiator up front, and the tube front that was on the car just wouldn't allow for that. The way the bars come across, they come across high, and it was gonna get in the way of a lot of things. So, being that we just finished the grub worm build earlier this year, that's kind of what he had in mind. So right there we go. This is an 85 millimeter BorgWarner from Jose. Sitting on a Maven mount. So we cut the front end where the other front come through originally right here. We put a slug inside of it, drilled some holes and welded that for extra hold right there, welded it all the way around. And then we basically copied what our front kit would look like, only our front kit sets under the fenders obviously, but we just kind of tried to mimic our design because that puts it really low where you can set the turbo right on the crossbar. Puts it just about perfect height. So that got it down and out of the way so we could put everything the way he wanted. He uses our F-body turbo headers. He already had those that he had previously bought. Got the streetcar billet flange, as always, on our builds. This has got all Turbo Smart turbo components, 50 millimeter blow valve, 50 millimeter gates. Also got one of our motor plates on it. Made him a little expansion tank there, or a fill tank, I guess you could say. Pretty small. You can fill the radiator up. This is kind of a universal radiator we get from our local hot rod shop. It doesn't come with any fittings on it, it's just the tanks and the core. So we put the fittings where we want it, or want them. See, we put AN fittings on everything. Got one up there, and then we got another one for filling it up. We put it high, so when you're filling it up, all the air will burp out of there. Come out of the steam ports right there. Into the fuel tank right here on this number four. Easy to fill up your system without any air in it. We used his original headlight bezels or assembly that goes across here. This is the way you do on our front kits if you have an LT car as well. You keep this and you just retrofit the headlight bracket onto it. But for his, because the front kit was in a different spot, we just made some rod and use some brackets there, tied it in on the outside right there. Got a 4.5 inch aluminum downpipe. Aluminum is the way to go. Lightweight, easy to work with.
you a bottom view here. See, we have a pump there. That's to scavenge the oil. Anytime you have a turbo setting this low, you're gonna need a scavenge pump if you don't have dry sump.
We changed a couple things about the cage. The original design had a floor section that was kind of built on top of the floor. It came here, went through here, jumped the tunnel, went back around. The only problem is he couldn't get his seat low enough. He was hitting his head on the top. So we changed, if it'll focus, we changed that big bar right there in the middle. Then we cut all of that stuff out. He didn't need anything over here because he's not worried about mounting a passenger seat. So by cutting that structure out, we could lower the seat where we needed it. The seat's not actually mounted for certain right now. We've got it pretty close, but he's gonna come and sit in the car and make sure we're getting it at the right height for him. Got our seat brackets here on a nice bar across there. It'll hold there. And then I got tabs going across here with a separate bar to hook his harness to, because there wasn't really a good attachment point for the harnesses on the bottom, so I'll put that across there. We also, instead of jumping the tunnel, we tried to use the bar that was already here, because the way his cage is made, it goes to the side there. So that kind of put us in a spot where to get him a front cross member, we had to slug that and go from there, which all this is what the SFI book says. So we're following the rules the best we can, but trying to get it close to a 25.5 as we can without just chopping up what he already had. Sorry, there's big gaps between my words. I'm trying to get all this videoed. We added these bars here to come down, and then we added these here. We always try to work with what a customer has. We don't tell them, hey, you got to chop everything out you've already paid for, because that's a lot of money wasted. So we try to work with what somebody brings us. So underneath, he's got a removable cross member that ties into the cage. He also has these nice subframes that we put in. Go all the way to the back, plate the frame. So just a lot of stuff done to this car. It's been here since June. He wasn't in a hurry. So we've just been kind of taking our time and taking care of all the little stuff he had on his list. But I think that's about it. Till the next job.